So she has a dystocia right now. Gotta figure out which one it is, the type, because the foal hasn't really moved very far since the bag presented, and we only see one hoof. Tip the nose up so it gets over the pelvis. Straighten it between the two legs. So.
I mean, I feel contractions here, like okay. At her vulva, but okay. It's like it's holding the vulva in.
Right, the vagina isn't contracting. And the uterus. Yeah. You're gonna start pulling on it? Since 3:25, so haven't seen my feet in a while. Start pulling now. Well, I've got the nose and the mouth. I'm just keep going. To reposition it. The whole body is sideways. It didn't fully turn in the when it came up out of the womb. So its head's diagonal like that. It didn't complete the 180 degree turn.
I feel the head. Yeah. It feels like right here. Right.
The head's pretty big.
What is happening is, I don't really have the camera still on.
Hi, I have a mare in foal that started. It's not having contractions, and the foal only partially turned. Showtime's still gonna be.
Feel the nose, and I can feel the top of the head is kind of offset to the right. I've been trying to position it, but I can't bring the head forward by just pulling the hooves. So we need the mare to do more pushing, and her contractions are really, really soft. So by the time that comes out here, we're not sure if the foal will make it. However, the foal is in the correct position, so it should still have an oxygen supply. It's just the thing that we're running up against is
when that placenta detaches, which is something we won't know. We were really hoping that this foal would go well, but we've never foaled out Queenie before, and she's had multiple foals, so maybe she just takes longer. Something to be hopeful about. But it's not looking great, and the closest vet is about an hour away, which really is inconvenient when you need a vet here within half an hour. We'll see if the stuff is still probably attached, so it has an oxygen supply, and it's in the correct position for the most part. We just need to push so we can get that nose through, because we can't just pull the foal without her pushing. I mean, the foal made it this far, and she had a small contraction, but it's just... I'm shivering because it's cold. I can see my breath, and it's freezing cold. And Madison might be awake.
She'll wake everybody up when she starts crying, then.
Hopefully. Okay. I don't know, maybe you can give your mom a call.
What for?
If she can watch Madison while we're out here.
Household.
I don't know if they will hear her, but it's okay.
They'll hear her.
Yeah, she might have. You know, the odd laying down and rolling might have been the start, but she just hasn't been showing that agitation of labor that so many mares have gone into.
Okay, can you pull these legs out again? Traction here. Pressure on you. The foal's not sliding back easy as it won't get out. Come on. Up, up, up. Thank you. once we get the head out, how much of most of the body is turned. She's not getting, yeah, she's not pushing it, turning it. Gotta just, yeah, there you go. Gotta get in there.
She's having that little contraction.
Keep her down. Put her up on her chest.
On her chest.
And get her hind up and then we can squeeze.
She needs, or she or he needs
take deep breaths. Get back here, take some vitals.
Towels, if you can grab one with your one arm.
Of course I can. I brought out that little Drop this out. I think it'll fit.
Otherwise, we still have Wilty's little sweater.
Right now, she's got mine. Good idea that the vet is coming because she still needs to have contractions to pass the placenta. Thank you for the full blanket. It's donated by a fan. It might be a little big.
Do we have an old sweater of Madison's? Here's the blanket first.
Let me tell.
So people know why we weren't freaking out. Brenda, mostly not.
Well, I was worried.
The reason I wasn't freaking out is it hadn't been 30 minutes since the water really broke. The foal was moving, and the placenta hadn't shown. So what that means is the foal, the placenta is still attached to the inside of the mare. And so the foal is still getting all the nutrients, all the oxygen, it's still oxygen. It's receiving everything it needs from the mare. And so they're still perfectly fine, perfectly safe. You have time to move them around and pull them out. So that's why I wasn't worried and rushing, you know, as though if it were worse, like a red bag or upside down or whatever. So I just wanted people to be aware of that. It wasn't an extreme position or situation yet, and now everything's fine.
We need the placenta, so I think that turned out still good.
Take a few minutes. I'm still waiting for him to call me back.
Did you call him?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we still have some of Madison's like two-teen clothes? That's what we use on Wilty.
But we don't have anything smaller. That is 2T.
All right.
I need to wash my coat. Maybe I'll call work and go in a little late today.
God dang it, my arm. Oh. Alright.
What?
phone was in my pocket where I couldn't hear it. Set it out for that call. Hi, this is Taylor. I called with a message about the emergency with the foaling. Sorry, my phone was in my pocket and I couldn't hear it. So we were able to, we got the foal out. Yeah, we finally were able to, yeah, twist the foal enough to be able to pull it out. So at this point, the placenta isn't out yet. I'm taking vitals on everybody. If the placenta comes out, not like, I guess I can, I'll check it myself, but what time do you get into the office? I'm thinking about maybe just bringing it over there for you to take a quick look at it and come in. So you don't have to drive all the way out here for an emergency call just to look at a placenta. She hasn't been having any contractions, so that's the biggest problem. We were able to get the foal out, but I don't know, again, whether or not she's going to get that placenta out without contractions. See if any progress is made with the placenta coming out, and then
she's just been down.
If it does start moving out, I'll just wait and bring it out to you at around 8, so you can do a quick inspection of it.
Mm-hmm. Hey, congratulations, Showtime! You're a new dad.
Right. No, there's, it's just, you know, the normal part hanging out with the white bag that was hanging out, allantoic sac is hanging out, and part of the umbilical cord, it's just, so anyway, I originally was for you to come out and, you know, help turn the foal, if you had some drugs to relax or something, but we have the foal out, and at this point, it's just checking the placenta to see if anything gets left inside once it comes out, if it comes out, so, yeah. And they get the weight to pull it out. It's not long enough. Okay. Then do you want me to wait, like, let me see what time it is. If there's no progress in 3 hours, do you want me to call? That gives you time to take a nap or whatever before work. Oh, fun. Okay, well, if there's no progress, I'll give you a call and we'll bring her in to get some oxytocin or something. All right, thank you very much. Bye. Well, she's been doing calls all night long, so she's like, hooray, I've had one nap tonight.
I'm sure the vets are happy to hear. So you did follow up with Dr. Clark, though?
I have not. I know.
He was on his way.
He was on his way?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
You didn't hear that from him?
No. Would have been nice.
But
to
he
know.
can definitely come out here to check her for placenta.
Yeah, I'll talk to him about it. he'll probably turn around and go back to sleep.
Yeah, he'll probably be happy to know that she's that she, the foal's
hey,
alive.
We were finally able to get it turned enough and pull the foal out, and it's alive and well.
But she's still alive?
She's not having, yeah, she's not having any, you know, outward contractions at all. So the placenta is barely sticking out. I didn't know if you wanted to still take the time to come out here, or if you want to wait a few hours. Okay. Mm-hmm. It was, the whole thing started at 3:25. And I'm trying to figure out how long the foal's been out. It's been out for at least 5 minutes, maybe 10. I've been kind of running around after it happened, so I didn't even think to call. She's lying down, eating.
Hasn't been up since
the fall. We haven't got her up and moving around yet. Figured we'd give her some time to rest. She's an old girl. Yep. Yeah, no, well, there were no contractions, and the foal had only turned probably 75% of the way.
I would say she had mild, very, very light contractions, though.
Yeah, so it was in there enough for me to kind of push and twist and turn to get the head straight enough and then pull, and it slowly twisted as it was coming out. No, it's still in there. We're going to get up and walk around. I just figure. Right. All right. I'll let you know what happens. Yeah, well, in this case, I don't think it would have been possible anyway. Right, yeah. It worked. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we've got some bandages. She's one of our larger minis, but she's about the size of her. Oh yeah, Queenie. She's the oldest one we have, about the size of a yearling Caspian. Right, yeah, it's all right. Okay, thank you very much. All right, bye. It's already on the road. All right, so we've got to get her up.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, well, that should hopefully stimulate contractions, even internal contractions, but just get that stupid thing moving, so let's just get her, move her up in here a little bit. Come on, honey. Oh, up. I guess she didn't like the idea of the roll. There we go.
No wonder you're checking when you're having those first contractions that you're holding.
Okay, and all right. Can you come tie this up? My entire... Still not good at tying knots with one hand.
And a slippery slip knot.
If you need, I can go get some thread or some string.
Just
double half inch, sorry. Way that slides right out.
Yeah, it's juicy.
All right, let me. Oh, I need a new one.
Full coat. You want me to put it on her yet?
Stomach louder than her heart. Leg is in my way. Gotta keep an eye on this foal, see when she's gonna try eating. Gosh.
Some really long slippers on those legs and on those feet.
Check on average.
I
Alright, so basically waiting on the placenta to come down all the way. She doesn't seem to be having external contractions, but it is moving. Foal is fantastic, up and walking around rather quickly, nice and active, as you can see. And Queenie seems to be no worse for wear. I'm just trying to get vitals on them. It's kind of hard to do with one hand. And then we will leave them alone for a while and let them do their thing.
Watch for the meconium. Watch for the meconium.
Yeah, I've got a down on the ground the an enema.
Okay. Sorry, it was. I also.